Hello friends. In this tutorial, I will teach you how to make sea and water waves. First, I create a vector layer and rename it to sea. And I draw a rectangle with the shapes tool. I select it with the select shapes tool. In the effects section, I select the gradient option. I create blue and pale blue and adjust them. I create another vector layer and rename it to wave. I select the shapes tool and try to make a wave with the rectangle. I will add two more points. I select all the points and make the wave a little bigger with the transform tool and holding the alt button. I select the wave with the select shapes tool and change its color. I also reduce the opacity a little. From the effects section, I select the soft edge option. I write the blur radius value as 7. I put the slider in frame 1 and click on the scene with the transform tool to create a keyframe. I put the slider in frame 30 and change the location of the points. I copy keyframes 1 with Ctrl and C and paste them in frame 60 with Ctrl and V. I select the last keyframes and right-click and select the cycle option. I also activate the additive cycle option and press the play button. I select the transform tool. I put the slider in frame 1 and click in the scene to create a keyframe. And move the wave in frame 36. I put the slider in frame 60 and paste keyframe 1 in frame 60 so that the wave returns to its first place. I right-click on the last frame and select cycle. I also activate the additive cycle option and press the play button. Now I select the particle from the layers section. I put the wave layer inside the particle layer. From the particle options section, I set its values. I choose it and put it in the right place. I press the play button. I press Ctrl plus R to render the scene and see the details better. You can change the particle mode with the randomize button. Now I insert a picture of an island and place it in the desired place. You can download or buy these photos from different sites. In this layer, I draw the sky with the rectangle tool. I go back to the wave layer to increase the distance between the points. In this way, the movement of waves becomes slower. Now I will render so you can see the final work. Thank you for being with me until the end of this tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Bye until the next video.